a big headline crossing the Bloomberg terminal.
A big headline, quite the headline, John, for two companies that the U.S. government has a vested interest in. In a statement, we heard from the Nvidia CEO Jensen Huang, who called this a historic collaboration. As part of the deal, Intel is going to use Nvidia graphic technology in upcoming PC chips, and Nvidia will use some of Intel's processors in order to meet the demand from AI data centers. The idea here being that they're really going to work together when it comes to some of this chip development. And it follows, of course, a recent push from this administration to bolster the domestic chip supply chain. Of course, last month, President Trump signing that deal that gave the U.S. government a 10% stake in Intel in a bid to sort of repurpose some of the existing CHIPS Act money. And I'll also point out that Japan's SoftBank made a surprise $2 billion investment in the company last month, too, amid this mounting pressure from the administration for this sort of money to be put up in order to clinch these trade deals. Now, I do want to point out one pretty important stat from this story that's now on the terminal. Analysts estimate that at some point next year, Nvidia will pull in more revenue per quarter than Intel gets in a year. Of course, John, as you well know, this White House, this president has really shored up ties with Nvidia as the company now finds itself really at the center of some of these sensitive trade negotiations.
Lisa, this is a really important development. You just listened to what Tyler was talking about then, the president's involvement in all of this. What's his objective? Build out domestic foundry capacity, one. What needs to happen after that? Someone needs to use it. And we've been talking about this over the last month. Who would be pushed to use it? This is not about the push anymore. Nvidia essentially is telling you they're ready to use it. They're ready to partner with Intel to make this happen.
Yeah, and specifically on certain chips for PCs and other devices, the question is whether this is going to be a big effort or whether this is going to be more performative. And this is something that we've asked when it comes to China and the Huawei move earlier, this idea of, is the technology comparable, or is it going to be tough to move away from, say, TSMC and Taiwan for the U.S. chip manufacturers?
Intel, higher again, up by 18% in the pre-market. Annmarie on the ground in the U.K. Annmarie, I imagine this announcement is music to the ears of the president.
Absolutely. The president has almost become, what, a co-CEO of Intel, putting a lot of pressure, one can imagine, on a lot of these companies since, as Tyler mentioned, almost 1 month ago to the day, the U.S. government decided to take that 10% stake in Intel. And the question, Jonathan, you, me, and Lisa sat around the table and asked, who is going to be next to either buy these chips from Intel or invest in more money to make sure that Intel could once again become a national champion? So on one front, you once again have what many would maybe call unconventional, what the U.S. government did. But certainly this is going to mean that more support could be flowing into the company like Intel. And then to Lisa's point, what did we hear today out of Huawei, out of Beijing? This highlights a core issue for the United States. Huawei basically announced a multi-year plan to take on the dominance Nvidia has in the marketplace. Howard Lutnick, the Commerce Secretary, has said time and time again, we have to make these chips in the United States. We have to make sure we are a dominant player in this. We cannot lose to China. Jensen Huang told me himself he doesn't feel like China's behind. They're right up against them in terms of where they are in the market and in AI technology. And the Commerce Secretary has said we have to make these chips in the U.S. We can't rely on Taiwan. So from a national security perspective, this really is in line in something we've seen from this White House and once again highlights, I would be absolutely shocked if the president and his team had no influence on this, highlights the heavy hand they are really taking in the semiconductor industry.